melting the wax. Candle making 101.
Instead of our regular white candles, we are going to make Christmas candles.
So what do we have here?
What we have here is a concentrated color dye. It's called Hunter Green. And then we also have our scent to add to the candles.
Christmas spruce.
Christmas spruce. So we're going to have a nice pine scent.
Christmas in September.
Absolutely.
Explain.
Also, so here we have the color dye, and if you can see the label here, this little block will color up to 20 pounds of wax. So what we're doing today...
How many pounds do we have?
We're probably going to do about 5 pounds today. So
you're going to cut it?
I'm going to cut it into fifths, because we like the fifths. So this is about the amount of dye that we're going to be using today.
What color is it?
This is Hunter's Green. Okay. They also, whenever you make the candles, you don't want to have too much dye in your candles.
So you're going to melt that in within the wax that you're melting down
yep,
right now.
Yep, to add a little bit of color.
Right.
You have to be careful how much dye you use because it can affect how your wick operates.
Burn ratio?
Yeah, how your wick operates. So then if you come over this way, these are actually we've cut our candle wicks. Take this off. Ideally, your candle should be no more than 9 inches, and you can use from the tip of your middle finger to the thumb to get an idea as to what.
Well, that's good for what we need to use with our lanterns.
Right, exactly. So what I've done is I've cut these so that we can double up on them. So we'll make two candles out of each strand, and then I allowed enough left over so that we can drape it over our drying rack.
There we go.
So you'll see that. You know, once it works out, we're going to have about a 9-inch candle on each of these.
Sounds good. So primitive candle making here at Camp Liberty.
As far as the Christmas spruce, we're going to have to...
I put it all in.
No, you can't. Actually...
It smells so good.
It should be 30 drops per pound. Unfortunately, we don't have a dropper here at camp, so we're just going to sort of estimate it. Okay, so what we have here is a Sterno can, and we have this built up so that whenever we take the wax that is boiling on the fire... We maintain a lower heat. We won't want it too hot because if you dip your candles, the wax will continue to melt and not adhere to the wick. Okay, so we have that burning. Okay, so the wax is melting rather well. And we're going to add in our dye cube. We're continuing to melt the wax there. You can see it's starting to take on some color.
I found a really nice burn.
So we're going to just go ahead and grab the wax
out of here
and set it on our stand. And again, we have the Sterno can that's going to maintain some of the heat. And wait right here. So you can see here, if you get real close and look down deep, you can tell this is turning into a nice evergreen color. We still have some wax at the bottom that I'd like to melt, so we thought of putting on the over the Sterno to melt from the bottom. And it shouldn't be too much longer. You can see here, a little bit more to melt. When that's ready, then we'll start our dipping process. But before we do that, we also want to obviously add our evergreen scent. Thank you. We're breaking down the wax a bit from the very bottom so that we have some depth for our wicks. But we definitely want to add our scent, evergreen scent. So if you want to get a close up on this.
It's like a pretty, I know, Texas. It's like a liberal hub almost in the state of Texas.
And Dallas is apparently a lot like Pittsburgh.
I'm not going to put too much more in there. So I would think we'd have maybe 4 to 5 pounds of wax here by the time we're done. And so I think we'll be okay. We'll at least have some pints in. Okay, so it looks like we're ready. I'm going to add just a little more scent.
She likes to go to the pool every day, and she's made a lot of new friends.
Oh, yeah. And we just simply take the wicks that we had measured out. Give it a quick dip. And we let it hang to dry a bit, to stiffen up and harden. So we're just going to continue working our way down here.
And there's like one other person. I'm probably going to stay silent.
I'm going to take the... dip as far down as you can, because at the bottom you will get some drippage. The wick won't be there, and we'll have to cut off the excess wax. So we try to take advantage of as much wick that we have available for each of the candles. Okay, so we have Kirsten here helping us now through the process.
It's all laid out trash in place,
right? Yeah, it hasn't been too bad. I'd say there's like an equal amount of trash.
Okay, so we're going to go through the rest of these, and we'll touch base whenever we start the next dip. In the meantime, we are heating some additional wax into the in the fire pit, because over time, obviously, our wax supply will diminish over there. So we're in the process of melting some additional wax. Okay, so we finished the first round. We have approximately 48 candles in total, keeping in mind that each of these will be cutting in half. So we're letting them cool down just a tad, and then we'll go for the second dip, and we'll continue to repeat the process until we get the desired thickness. And typically, if I back up here, you'll see that we want them to look at least like this as far as thickness goes. So what we have to do, as I had mentioned before, sometimes you get a lot of drippage at the end of the candle, so what you want to do is clip off that excess wax.
There's a lot.
It's beautiful.
And then, of course, we're putting the tips back into the little pot, and we'll remelt that down. So far, we've had 5 dippings. And you can see the thickness of the candle, so we have quite a few more to go. So you see, we have a good way to go yet.
Mm-hmm. Just looking good. It smells like a pine forest here.
Yep, absolutely. But after every 2 or 3 dips, we keep trimming the bottoms off.
This is the colonial way.
Yep.
Yep. What's the smell?
Pine.
Mmm.
Yeah. It's interesting. This is our 13th?
This is the
14th. Oh, 14th.
Okay, so what level are we on here? 16?
I'm on
17 dips so far.
I figured not.
There's a comparison. We have a ways to go yet.
I'm on 21.
21 dips so far.
You went down.
I'm working on your holes here for the morning.
Dipping
candles in the wax.
Candles.
Dipping. So one dip.
Two dip.
One dip per set, right? Correct?
And then you go through the whole line and then you dip again.
Okay. Well, they're looking great.
One.